Perfect. Time. Καλημέρα. I'm Savina again, and it is my honor to welcome you in my country. Creativity is the guide for the transformation of original and uncommon attributes to innovative combinations and extraordinary experiences. Coffee flavor combinations, as with food flavors, when masterfully paired up, can lead to innovative creations and enable the generation of a flavor matrix, not primarily apparent. Based on the science and theory of food, there are two kinds of taste pairings that work well together: complementary tastes and balancing tastes. Complementary tastes define the ones that highlight one another, like salty and sweet, while an example of balancing taste is the sour and sweet. Judges, I'm here to share with you how a unique coffee pairing of two individual coffees gives us the opportunity to experience flavors that could not be found so clearly in the coffee unless the chemical compounds of those two had been combined. During my coffee trip a couple of months ago at Panama, at the area of Silla de Pando, I came across with my first coffee. Cultivated at 1600 meters above the sea level, the Panamanian Gesa from 90 plus Gesa Estates, Lot 188, a 2023 crop, proved to be the perfect canvas to create something signature. The perfect match for this Gesa, the rare species of Eugenoides from Immaculata Farm, located in the region of Valle de Cauca, Colombia, grown at approximately 1900 meters above the sea level, harvested just 2 months ago. Having picked the coffee cherries at their optimal ripeness, both coffees followed the natural whole cherry oxygen control maturation before drying. During the roasting process, despite the common practice in blending after roasting, my team and I figured out that coffees which are to be blended and already share similar physical properties come to the first crack at the same time and complete their development in a similar way. That is why I roasted my coffee in a singular batch 3 days ago for 6 minutes, achieving 80 actron and 13% of development. And even prior to roasting, to further add on the exact homogeneity and components exchange, my Gesa and Eugenoides were put together as green beans into a small container for 14 days and frequently agitated by hand. During this period, one specific lactone of Gesa, methyl, which is a common threat among all tropical fruits, binds itself to other ingredients of Eugenoides, giving as a result the before mentioned generation of flavors that didn't exist before. This continuous coexistence of those two distinctive coffee species, both at the roasting and grinding phase, led to the desirable complexity and balance in the final cup. Now my recipe is 15 grams of coffee at approximately 700 microns. A 200 and 50 grams of water in a brew ratio 1 to 16.6. 80% of Gesa mixed with 20% of Eugenoides into my grey cannon dripper, which I chose for its aluminum construction that consistently sustains temperature levels during brewing to allow my coffee to develop its multi-dimensional character. I decided to use 3 isomeric pulses of 70 grams each. Now, starting with a pre-wetting phase, I am adding 40 grams of water, 93 Celsius degrees to assist CO2 release and prepare my coffee bed for the next 3 pulses. My water comes directly from the spring of Babito, located in Panama, so close to my Gesa, 160 ppm and equal concentration of calcium and magnesium to get a juicy character. The pH level is at 7.2 to ensure the vibrance in your cups. Following my coffee's creative character, in front of you there is a menu. Please pull out the transparent part to reveal the complete description of the coffee profile. I'm going to take you through all the information that is already written, so relax and feel free to take the menus backstage. Starting with the aromas, my coffee welcomes you with its fruity and delicate notes. You will find ripe mango and pineapple also peach, cotton candy, and floral hints. In the hot flavors, you will find peach, sweet papaya, mango, and ripe pineapple. In the warm flavors, apricot, melon de Guadeloupe, the sweetest one, red plum, and marron chestnut. As it cools, it gives a fruity character. You will find nectarine, pineapple, lemon jelly, and stewed bergamot. The aftertaste is gentle and keeps a fruity character throughout all temperatures. As it cools, you will also experience some Earl Grey notes, and it is long and sweet all the way from hot to cold. The acidity is malic, medium in intensity. As it cools, my coffee combines a malic and citric acidity, medium to high in intensity now. A coffee with a high and elegant sweetness all the way, reminding of beeswax. Having a honey-like quality. The mouthfeel when hot is smooth with a juicy texture, medium in intensity. As it cools, it turns syrupy and gets more rich and round. An overall unique coffee with an exceptional balance between acidities, sweetness and flavors that masterful pairs delicacy and intensity with parting complexity in your mouth. In order to evaluate the aromas, please swirl 3 times every moment you come closer to this experience. Please enjoy. Enjoy. Enjoy, and I will be back. The cups I'm serving you are handmade by me using stoneware clay to keep the contents temperature constant for more. They are also shaped to protect the aromas and highlight the sweetness of my coffee. May I serve you? Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir. It's now time for you to completely confirm this amazing cup, following my instructions. For the hot temperature, use the cupping spoon provided, selected to enhance your tasting experience with a kind and smooth edge. For the warm and cold temperature, drink directly from the cup, holding the coffee in your mouth for at least 3 seconds. Time to enjoy. I'm Savina, and I hope you enjoyed with me the creative process of a coffee genesis as food science explains. It has been a pleasure serving you judges, and that's my time.